In neoclassical theory, we analyze the gains from trade with the help of both demand and supply sides. Basically, Ricardian model is a supply side model. This considers only the production side and opportunity cost. Now we will come to neoclassical theory. Initially, we will come to the autarkic equilibrium and then how can we reach the gains from trade after the country engages in trade. So in autarkic equilibrium, there are two sides. Number one, production or supply side, and second is the consumption or demand side. The production side of a country is represented by the production possibilities frontier or PPC, production possibilities curve. So let's, in production possibilities curve, we consider number one, resources, they are constant. The state of technology, that is constant, and resources are efficiently utilized. So from the efficiency in production, we get the production possibilities curve of the country. And unlike Ricardian theory, here we will consider that the factors are not perfectly mobile within both sectors. That is the condition of imperfect mobility and increasing opportunity cost of production. So let's draw the PPC. The vertical axis represents the quantity of Y produced, horizontal axis represents the quantity of X produced. So this is a two country, two commodity. We are not considering about the factor. So TT is the production possibilities curve that represents the locus of different combinations of two commodities that a country can produce in these conditions. Resources constant, technology constant, and resources are efficiently utilized. So the slope of PPC gives us marginal rate of transformation between X and Y. Now, under autarky, this PPC, the production possibilities curve, is the consumption possibility locus of this country. Now, at which point the country will finally produce? That will be determined once we can derive the, we will draw the consumption. So we will draw the community indifference curve that represents the preference pattern of the country between two commodities. So now let's draw the CIC. So E0 is the autarkic equilibrium. The scope of community indifference curve gives us the marginal rate of substitution between X and Y. So this equilibrium point indicates marginal rate of substitution between X and Y equals to marginal rate of transformation between X and Y. So MRSXY is exactly equal to the opportunity cost of X in terms of Y under autarky. So what about the price ratio? If we want to find the price ratio under autarky, this is the interaction of demand and supply. The price ratio in autarky will be given by the straight line P, which is tangent to CIC and PPC at the point of equilibrium. So equals to, we can write that minus Px by Py. We are giving a negative because if I want to increase the consumption of X, I have to sacrifice the consumption of Y. Now let us introduce what happens if the trade takes place. This country is a small country which cannot influence the international prices. So, what we can see, the country is a price taker in the international market. And if we see, Pxi is the international price of X and Pyi is the international price of Y, the international terms of trade will be given as Pxi by Pyi. And if international terms of trade is different from the, is not equals to the Px by Py autarkic price ratio, the country can gain from trade. So we have to remember that once the country enters into trade, the international terms of trade line will become the consumption possibility locus of the country. If the markets are perfectly competitive, then post-trade production equilibrium will be determined by the condition of MRTXOY equals to minus PX by PY. Sorry, it will be PXI by PYI. International. So post-trade production equilibrium will be attained by the equality of marginal rate of transformation and international terms of trade. So let us consider the slope of PI, straight line PI gives the international terms of trade, or the slope of PI gives the ratio of PXI and PYI. So post-trade production point will be E1, and the straight line PI is the consumption possibility locus after trade. So what will be the consumption equilibrium? So equilibrium in consumption will be given as the marginal rate of substitution between X and Y, that will be equal to minus Px by Py. That means the slope of community indifference curve equals to slope of international TOT. So as per the condition, the new equilibrium will be attained at higher indifference curve I1. So by this, by engaging in trade, the country moves from point E0 to E2. That means there is a welfare gain. The country moves to higher community indifference curve. Now let's consider what will be the volume of trade here. So post-trade production of X is OX0 and post-trade production of Y is OY0. And post-trade consumption of Y is OY0 and OY1, and post-trade production of Y will be, X will be OX1. So x0, x1 is the surplus production of x, and y0, y1 is the deficit consumption of y. So this is the gap in consumption and production. This is the total consumption and this is the total production of y after trade. So this will be import of y, and here after trade production of x is ox0 and consumption of x is ox1. So domestic supply is ox0, domestic demand is ox1. So this excess supply will be export of x. So hence this is the trade triangle and this is the import of y, this is the export of x, and by which the country moves to higher indifference curve I1. This is the welfare gain from trade of a country.